A note with a bougainvillea that I like so much in the window. And Balzac that I don't like so much. He's trying to destroy my shirt. And he did, he placed a hole. Anyway, positive psychology in practice and death. Why? For lack of a better subject. And since I'm in a bad mood on account of this guy, why not go all the way and think of death? It will be the end of him if he tries another trick. It's good he doesn't understand. He only knows the local language. Anyway, death. Why death? It's not just at random. Not 100%. The Economist, the latest issue, which actually was available online last night, has death as the main story, and the issue of the end on the cover. Well suggested by a rose that is dying. Indeed, it is an important issue, pardon, not just in economic and other terms, as stated in the article. I didn't know, but there's a lot of money spent on the last year of pensions. But in terms of positive psychology and well-being, happiness, if you will, it is an important issue. Interesting, because aside from the economic, the huge spending, the fact that there are so many surgical interventions, so much going on in medical terms in that last period, affects the well-being of the individual. In what sense? Of course, there will be patients who are terminally ill and would rather have all chemotherapy, all the operations in the world, only to survive. And I don't know what my reaction would be, but the question, the issue raised in The Economist, think about the last wishes, what you want to do, you want to be unplugged, you want to be operated in on, even if that just means a few more months of pain and torture for some. So that's an important issue. And I think it's in his last year, one patient out of five has a surgical intervention, and they spend the last one in three spends the last month or so. The statistic don't matter here in details. It's just that the sense that indeed there's it's bad, it's negative, it affects the well-being of the dying. Those who die in homes, in their own home or in institutions for the elderly, the retirement homes and whatnot, are better off. It's much worse to die after being operated and suffering times again and again, and dying in a hospital. Then it's much worse here than in the other. So there's an issue that quite often, even if the last the patient, the dying man, had provisions, he didn't want to be still plugged in, to have an operation, even if he was he was a vegetable or whatever. Quite often with the laws we have today and the attitude of today. Politicians cannot talk about this and others, because then there's a immediately a reaction, adversarial, that they have organized death panels and so on. But it's indeed important to think about it. It looks like there's no point in being and staying a vegetable in the last year, few months, and decisions about the last moments will be needed, not when one is unconscious, not when one is already unable to decide. And it's important to always look on the bright side of life. Monty Python, always look on the bright side of death, they say at one point in the same famous song, the end of Monty Python's Life of Brian. And having decided about that, îmi faci gău, idiotul. So stupid, he causes pain.